Cliff, if you don't mind, I would like to withdraw the question. Because, well, really, it's none of my business. I think people are people. I really do, Cliff, don't you? I don't think they should have to explain a thing. For example, if I paint my fingernails green, and, well, it happens that I do paint them green, someone should ask me why I say I think it's pretty. I think it's pretty, I reply. So, if anyone should ask about you and me one day, you have two alternatives. You can either say, oh yes, we're living in delicious sin, or you can simply tell them the truth and say, I met this perfectly marvelous girl in this perfectly wonderful place as I lifted a glass to the start of a marvelous year. Before I knew it, she called on the phone, inviting. Next moment, I was no longer alone, but sat reciting some perfectly beautiful verse in my charming American style. How I dazzled her senses is truly no less than a crime. Yes, I've this perfectly marvelous girl in my perfectly beautiful room, and we're living together and having a marvelous time!
Okay, Sally, I'm afraid it wouldn't work. You're much too distracting.
Distracting? No, inspiring. She tells me perfectly marvelous tales of her thrillingly scandalous life, which I'll probably use as a chapter or two in my book. And since my stay in Berlin was to force creation, what luck to fall on a fabulous source of stimulation. And perfectly marvelous too is her perfect agreement to be just as still as a mouse while I'm giving my novel a whirl. Yes, I've a highly agreeable life in my perfectly beautiful room with my nearly invisible, perfectly marvelous girl.
Okay, Sally, I just can't afford to... Do you have any money?
Yes, 6 marks.
Oh, God.
No, Cliff, please, just for a night or two, please.
I met this truly remarkable girl in this really incredible town, and she skillfully managed to talk her way into my room. I have a terrible feeling I've said a dumb thing. Besides, I've only got one narrow bed.